Saudi Arabia is a country overflowing with oil. It has an estimated oil reserve of 267 billion barrels, accounting for 17% of the world's oil reserves. The country's abundance of oil propelled them to be the biggest economy in the Middle East and the top 20 economy on the planet, making Saudi Arabia an oil superpower. However, this apparent blessing of natural resources actually can really damage the economy with the so-called resource curse. In this video, we will explain how the Saudi Arabian economy is cursed with too much oil, and how it can grow past this curse to be an economic powerhouse in the Middle East. First of all, we need to understand the concept of the resource curse. According to Investopedia, the resource curse is a term used to describe a paradoxical situation in which a country underperforms economically, despite being home to valuable natural resources. This can happen because too much of the country's capital and labor are concentrated in a single industry, and it failed to diversify its economy to other sectors. This term applies perfectly to Saudi Arabia, where the country is heavily dependent on oil, though not as bad as some other countries such as Angola or Venezuela. Since the discovery of vast quantities of oil in Saudi Arabia in 1938, the government has put huge amounts of money into building oil refineries. This is to be expected, since oil is one of the most valuable natural resources, and Saudi Arabia is home to several of the biggest oil deposits on Earth. This led to the present moment, when the economy is heavily dependent on oil. Oil revenues alone account for over half of the country's total exports, making the country vulnerable to drops in the price of oil. Too much concentration on oil can also limit private sector investment opportunities, and causes private investment to become dependent on government stimulus. The rise of renewable energy is also making things worse for Saudi Arabia. More and more countries have already begun to shift from non-renewable energy to renewable energy such as solar and wind energy, and this will plummet the demand for oil even more in the future. This is why Saudi Arabia is a classic case of the resource curse. And this is why diversification is of paramount importance for Saudi Arabia. And the government actually has noticed this from decades ago. The Saudi government has been trying to diversify its economy since the 1970s. However, the implementation of this goal has been unstable and the economy remains largely dependent on the price of oil. And right now, Saudi Arabia is undergoing a huge reform plan called Saudi Vision 2030. It is a program designed in 2016 with the goal of reducing Saudi Arabia's dependence on oil, diversify its economy, as well as develop the private sector such as infrastructure and tourism. To reduce Saudi's dependence on oil, it has to develop an alternative source of income for the government. And Saudi Arabia did this by increasing taxes and developing its sovereign wealth fund. In fact, the Saudi sovereign wealth fund is right now valued at $400 billion, easily one of the largest sovereign wealth funds in the world. Along with its sovereign wealth fund, the country is also trying to develop its tourism sector, and it continues to hope that tourism can be the backbone of the economy in the future. This is not easy, but it is actually quite possible when we account for the 2 million annual Hajj pilgrims that consistently bring $2 to $3 billion in revenue every year. The jobs created by the religious pilgrimage actually employs more people than the whole oil industry. And along with advancement in women's rights and education, the potential of Saudi Arabia's tourism is still there. Another important agenda of Saudi Vision 2030 is the privatization of state-owned businesses, and the government hoped to raise $55 billion over the next 4 years through privatization. The country hoped that privatization can encourage entrepreneurship and increase innovation in the non-oil sector. But there are growing concerns that Saudi Arabia is just a little too late on attempting diversification, especially because of the year 2020, when oil prices fall and tourism activities halted across the world. The Saudi Vision 2030 program is also critiqued by many journalists as overly ambitious, and the non-oil sector growth so far was insufficient for the program to be successful. Improving the private sector also turns out to be very hard, as most Saudi nationals are unwilling to work in the private sector, as wages are lower than the public sector. Currently, twice as many Saudi nationals work in the public sector rather than in the private sector, which significantly hinders the growth of the private sector. In conclusion, there are conflicting opinions on whether the Saudi Vision 2030 will work or not. In my opinion, the program so far has been successful in reducing dependency on oil and growing the private sector. But 2020 has really been a bad year for Saudi Arabia, as business activities have halted and that hinders the progress of the Saudi Vision 2030. What are your opinions on the matter? Leave a comment down below and also subscribe if you enjoy this video. And with that said, thank you for watching and see you next time.